invisible, tasteless, no smell, non-toxic, and the lightest molecule in the world. Hydrogen is the most abundant element in the universe. It is essential to human survival because hydrogen is crucial in the production of ammonia, a key fertilizer which supports our food supply. But scientists have long recognized that hydrogen has even more to offer in the world. With hydrogen, it is possible to produce energy. And when hydrogen produces energy, the energy is clean. Water is the only byproduct. For all its abundance, though, hydrogen is rarely found in free state. It is usually combined with oxygen, which makes water, or with carbon, which makes hydrocarbons or fossil fuels. To use hydrogen by itself, we have to split molecules. Splitting water is expensive, and splitting fossil fuels is polluting. Today, the world relies on fossil fuels to meet our energy needs. Across the globe, in 2022, of all of the energy consumed, 82% came from fossil fuels. To address climate change, the work has focused on renewable energy like wind, solar, hydroelectric, geothermal power, and biofuels. In the last 20 years, renewable share of the total energy mix has increased from 8 to 13%. Progress, yet we still have a lot of work to do. To understand the challenge we're facing to reduce our reliance on fossil fuels, there are two dynamics we need to consider. First, the growth rate of global energy consumption. It is continuously increasing, which means the amount of clean energy we need to produce to significantly reduce fossil fuel consumption gets bigger every year. Time is not on our side. Second, and the most difficult to perceive, is the size of the energy industry. It is gigantic. For perspective, if the fossil fuels consumed worldwide in one day were represented by a line of barrels of oil, the line of barrels would go around the Earth more than two times. And yes, each day. But there are more challenges for clean energy solutions. Even in sunny states like California, solar panels sit idle at night. And in windy states like Nebraska, wind does not blow constantly. We need renewable energy that can provide us a baseload power available 24/7. Fossils are doing that today. Manufacturing of solar panels and wind turbines rely on endangered minerals. Their installation requires larger quantities of materials like steel or cement, and renewables are more land intensive compared to fossils. Switching to renewables requires building a new infrastructure from scratch. It implies large expense of money and time and leaves stranded assets behind, including human resources in the oil and mining industries. If only there was a solution which has no limitations of such kind. Which brings me back to hydrogen. We are learning there may be another abundant, clean, cheaper, and even renewable way to get hydrogen. Natural hydrogen, also called white hydrogen. Naturally occurring geologic hydrogen found underground. Nature does the work for us. Deep within the Earth, natural reactions between water and iron-rich minerals produce hydrogen. These reactions are ongoing 24/7 and have existed since the early days of the planet, making hydrogen a renewable resource for us to tap for energy. We also theorize that there are vast stores of hydrogen in the center of the Earth that have been there since its formation. These are the two primary sources of natural hydrogen in the Earth I will focus on today. Because hydrogen is so light and diffusive, it naturally begins rising. On its way to the surface, it can accumulate in porous rocks. This is when it becomes available for us to harvest at scale. The biggest challenge is to reliably locate the sweet spots for drilling. My team and other scientists are working on this. If we don't harvest it, the hydrogen will find its own way up through cracks and fissures to the surface and will become either consumed by various reactions or lost in the atmosphere. This precious renewable resource has been escaping and is escaping as we speak, and will continue to do so because accumulations will never run dry. Hydrogen is self-replenishing. We can access or harvest natural hydrogen using a process similar to what the natural gas industry uses. By doing so, it will be possible to pivot from fossil fuels rapidly. This will give us the speed we need to achieve world's clean energy transition goals. Wow, you might say to me, it is too good to be true. If it is the case, why we are hearing about that only now? You sound like many investors I met. The idea that hydrogen exists below the surface of the Earth is not new. Hydrogen under the ground has been discovered as early as 1888 in my homeland, Ukraine, by the famous chemist Dmitry Mendeleev. This discovery and many others like it were classified as anomalies and not researched further. Back in 2011, when I delved into the realm of natural hydrogen, I found only a handful of individuals worldwide who were researching hydrogen underground. One of those people was a prodigious geologist, Vladimir Larin, for whom natural hydrogen was his life's work. He predicted huge quantities of deep-seated hydrogen as stored inside of the planet. He was the person who inspired me to explore natural hydrogen. As a scientist, my educational background is in chemistry, while my experience revolves around geochemistry. I like hard data and facts. Despite the lots of skepticism in the science community, I found a lot of data and research spread across a multitude of journals. It was clear that someone needed to consolidate the pertinent information. That someone ended up being me. After 7 years and nearly 500 publications and books, I finally released The Occurrence and Geoscience of Natural Hydrogen, a comprehensive review published in the Earth Science Reviews Journal. Thank you. It connected the dots between all the scattered facts, amassing a wealth of knowledge about natural hydrogen in one place. Which brings me to the next question. How much hydrogen is underground? The United States Geological Survey, using my review as a starting point, concluded there could be 10 trillion tons of hydrogen in the ground. If just 1% of that predicted in-place resource could be recovered, this would supply all the hydrogen we need for clean energy transition for hundreds of years, if we invest heavily and quickly. And there are more opportunities for hydrogen to replace fossil fuels. Right now, research is underway to accelerate the Earth's crust reactions to manufacture stimulated hydrogen, also called orange hydrogen. It will face many challenges, but if we can accomplish this feat, we could potentially meet 100% of worldwide energy demand using geologic hydrogen. Here is a scenario based on data and conservative predictions by the International Energy Agency that shows us what is possible by 2050. Renewable energies will continue to grow, multiplying solar and wind generation by 7, doubling biofuel production and other renewables. adding my estimate of harvesting 100 million tons of hydrogen annually by 2050, we can reduce our reliance on fossil fuels by one third. And when we crunch the numbers further into the future, we can see that natural hydrogen is the missing link in clean and renewable energy to make a significant impact much faster. The race has already started. In Nebraska, I founded and I'm managing a startup which drilled a well to harvest natural hydrogen. We are currently running tests before starting a pilot. This project is a true endeavor with plenty of unknowns and risks. Our project is first of such type in the USA, but other companies are actively getting into this emerging market. In our eyes, natural hydrogen is becoming a separate branch of the total energy industry. Hydrogen may be one of the most efficient molecules to combat the energy crisis. And it could be right under our feet. Thank you.